Hello, this is Gmodism Gmod Nerdy Channel, and today we are going to do a tutorial of how to make an ACF airship. So, we'll begin from scratch. Let's look into... we are going to choose a classic boat this time. Half-life 2 vehicle, this one. This nice old boat. Very fresh. And we want to put it straight like that. And we are now going to make the engine parts and steering section. So we are basically going to make a propeller. And for making a propeller, we're going into, we just choose like general and the small block, the smallest block. And we want to have a wooden propeller because that feels cool, basically. So two small of these wooden parts. And now we are going to have precision weld and just take negative one so it's a bit inside. And oh, we put 15 here, so we can choose the right degrees, and so it gets equal on both sides. So we can have like 15 degree snaps. So we're just going to have one. I think two is good. Like that. One, two. Like that. And then we are going to those, and just before we parent them, just weld these together. And we also want fin tool, so no lift. Apply that too. And now we are going to have a engine and a gearbox. We will just take differential inline small. I don't know, we can start at like, 0.22 for the final drive. And we, oh, oops. We are not going to have inline small. No. Yes. All right. Well, you know what? It will do. I usually use the straight gearbox, but for that we need to have a CVT or a gearbox with gears, and we are not going to bother with gears this time. So basically, they are working in a very equal way, actually. This white cube is going to be our wheel we're going to connect it to later. And we're going to change the weight of that and of those. I think 20 is good for the propellers. And we put 50 at this cube. And now we want an engine. And well, I usually use a plane engine, or you know, those radial engines. This time we're going to use another type of engine. I want to have a single engine because they exist, basically. We take this ridiculously large single. It will be nice. We're going to no collide this stuff. And just align it correctly to this gearbox. That this is just, you know, trying to be accurate. Like that. And now, that's basically the most important things, but we have to choose something to wall them on to look it to give it a better looks. So we're going down and we're going to choose some like this part is very nice for that application. And just no qualities. Whoops, not that one. This one. I'm just going to check. Yes, we have collision. Good. We're going to check the weight of this. That is too much. 2,500. Let's change it to, say, 100. Not 1,000. 100. Like that. And we also... let's check the weight of the boat. We have to have collision on the boat, otherwise we will fall out of it. Oops, wait. 250. Yeah, we maybe could make it a bit higher, actually. I think we put 400 on the boat. That is our base prop. And the nice with having a wooden boat as base prop is if you shoot it to pieces, well, everything will fall off. So it's a very bad prop to choose if you're making a kind of warship. But I really like the looks of airships with boats on. I'm sorry, we're first putting this here. And then we move the whole contraption when it's done. Well, well. It's important that we get it right. Now we're going to weld some stuff. This engine to that one, and the gearbox to that, and the gearbox to the engine. This prop, we're going to put as an angle. Axis, there. So now basically it will be okay. We will move this. And something. We want to no collide these wooden propellers because otherwise we will break them soon. And that's not cool. Then we need another prop to make this contraption look a bit more cool. Let's just choose a cosmetical thing. We're just going to have, yes, we're going to have a stove. And we're going to have it in a very low weight, like 5. It's just for the looks. But now we're going to weld this to the boat, and the stove to the boat, we don't have to weld them together. And, well, this is one of the basic constructions so far. Now we want to put down some wire stuff to make the whole thing work. So we need a pod controller. Let's see if I can find it. I mean, it was so much easier when they called it just advanced pod controller, because then it started on A and it was always highest up in the list. Well, it was better in the old days, but in the really old days, in the old days we didn't have ACF, so will be not true. And we need a constant value, and we're just going to have one constant value for the home contraption. So we want to have room for the first one we leave at 0, the last one we leave at 1, and we want 20 here. And I think we want negative 20 here. That's right. So we are going to spawn our little constant value in a good spot for wiring things. Like there, a bit out of the way, so you don't have to, it doesn't block the site. It's hidden inside. And now we're going to wire activate to activate throttle. Oh, I'm sorry, we're just going to paste in some more weights. I know why it was I forgot the value. 100, of course. Like that. And we want a multiply gate. So let's find a multiply gate under Artemy gates and multiply. And just hit it inside. And also, we're going to paste two multiplied gates more for the steering later on. So, well, let's scroll down to, whoops, wrong menu, wire, and wire tool. And we're going to put throttle on this only multiply gate, A on 100, and B on 'space'. So this is the throttle button I just chose. And well, we are just going to spawn a... We're going to hold E till we get the advanced pod controller. And, well, the engine seems to be working. Let's just connect the engine to the gearbox and the gearbox to the wheel. Or, not wheel, but propeller center or something. Well, now let's test it. We don't have the gas bag on, but so you can see it moves. And now we can see it moves in the correct direction, which means we don't have to negate the final drive on the differential. So that's cool. Now we want to put in a steering function. And, well, I think I want to do something new, and I want to put the steering in the front instead of the back. That means we have to have two plates, one to just help us steer a bit, and I've been asked several times to use S-props instead, so we find some good S-props for the fins. This one should be adequate. Or this one even more, maybe. The problem with S-props is that it takes a bit more time to choose, as you have so many options, but I guess that's a good thing. Like that. And this one. Yep, no collide, both of them. And, well, here I will have the steering, basically. We're going to do a rig that reaches out and make an axis here in the front of this one. And we are going to have a fin, a rigid fin in the back to not make it glide away in weird ways when we steer. Because if we hadn't have this, it would slide around like a control, like a car which someone have lost control of. So well. Let's get to the rig. And I want to, well, there is no reason to change the material later. We're just going to change them now so they look nice. Yeah, rust. I like rust. Bit darker tone. Like that. And, well, I'm just going to check that the angle is right. We want to have that. Alright, maybe we want anti-slip stuff that you can stand on and shoot down from. We're just going to spawn these for later on. Well, we just do it now. Oh, do not overlay this, I'm just kidding. Because then we will fall through them. And that's very not good. And we check the weight on them. And they are 50, and that's good. Let's weld them to the base prop. So this is the plan. You walk around this ship. Whoa, and you don't jump off it. You walk around this ship, and you can just tilt over and stand on this ladder and, like, shoot down. So, let's continue with the steering. That one could be cool. And the weight of this is unimportant. 20 is cool. This is to make it not look weird, basically. Because before we fasten this with the weld, we're going to take axis and aim it at this one, and then we are going to right-click it here. And before we forget to do it on the rest of this contraption, we're going to do it right-click and this one. This will hinder it from, you know, all these parts just wobbling around. That is unnecessary and will cause some lag. It's smart to weld and axis stuff to a base prop. And well, let's weld this. And we're going to have a little bar. And we're going to no collide this. Right click so it's not colliding to anything. And we're going to check the weight of it, and it's 65, and well, this is 23. I think this will work. We're welding this to the base prop. And well, now actually we are going to go to hydraulics. And I think a single hydraulic will do. And we're just going to make it invisible for the simpleness of it. And whoops, wrong end. Weld it to here. Not weld, point or fasten. So you know it's invisible, but it hydraulic goes from this end to this plate here, so we can swing it around back and forth, also known as steering. Well, anyways, now we check the length of this, and this is quite important. We see it's 55.36, and we're going to check that it's really straight, and it's not. I think this is better. And now we're going to back and check the hydraulic again. and is 54.58. And now we want to go at constant value. And the first number, we want to write exactly that. 58. And of course, you write what your hydraulic says it is. And we're just going to update this. And we also want to spawn a add gate. Add. Scroll down to wire again. First, we want to aim this at the value we just wrote in. So we have this gate now says it is that length. And then we're going to wire the length to the add gate. And on B and C, we will to do two different wire gates. And well, A, we will wire to negative 20 on the left gate, and the right gate, we will wire it to positive 20. And then we're going to put on the controls A and the other one D. And now I just put on completely random and we simply check if it's cool. Well, let's increase it. So, get in. And you know what? I've accidentally wired them correctly. If I hadn't, we have to put the B's and the two different B's on the left and the right multiply gates and put them reversely on A and D. So A and D we will use for steering. And space for throttle. You can also join throttle to a you can also wire the throttle so you can activate it with the button, which makes you can have it on while walking around, but that can be very difficult in high speeds. So well, this is the hardest part. So the hardest part of this one is done, and this is a good place to save the game. So save game. I usually forget to save my games, and that can be very unfortunate sometimes. We're going into Team Fortress, I've decided. And we're going to choose this white tank, because it looks quite cool. And we're going to turn it upside down. Ship, anyways. And now, if you're a very boring person, you can just weld it to the base prop, the boat, and put on some decorational ropes. However, if you are not a boring person, you must put lots of ropes. So, we're going to fasten the ropes. This end, we will put a rope here, a rope here, because I think it's I think it's cool when the whole thing is upheld by just the ropes. And of course, that can lead to some instability, but it's completely worth it. Because, it's realistic. In a very cool way. So So this is the most important ropes, but we need some more actually. We need diagonal ropes so that it won't rock forward and backwards. And for some added stability, we want to have a X shape on the ropes back here. Like that. This should be quite stable. So we're going to try it by unfreeze it. Is this elastics? No. Well, anyways. I mean, it's quite. Well, we will see when we fly. I think it will do. Otherwise, we have to put some more ropes and we will not weld them. And now I forgot to weld this fin back. That should be good. Let's weld it. We're going to make these stuff fins also. So we want to take our fin tool and we're just going to have no lift. 50, I think, is good. On both that, on the forward and the back. And well, let's get to the balloons. And now we're going to spawn balloons to see how many we need. And we start at 2 balloons at 2000. Then we will spawn balloons later with a nicer way. This is too much. Let's start at 2 with 5000. That might be too much also. Well, now I have 2 with 5000 on, and that was too little. So we're going to change it to 6000 in lifting force. This is no ordinary helium balloons. This is quite strong balloons, as you might see. And well, now we are going to make the weight controlling unit that makes us go up and down. And for this airship, I would estimate that 300 is a quite good weight. So well, weight adjustable. We want it to spawn. We spawn it on the tank. I usually have them on the tank. So, and now we're going to have advanced input. And we want to increase the weight by F. Decrease it by R so that we can fly the whole airship with one hand. And we start at 300, the maximum is 300 and the minimum is 0. Changes per second we are going to lower by 100. Like that. And the advanced input we put on the stove. Actually, it's quite sensible to have a stove on a airship, as you could use it for heating the gas in an air tank to make it go higher or lower. But well, that's nice. Anyways, let's weld wire the weight to the wire advanced input. And now we're going to unfreeze the whole contraption. So this is basically our done airship. We are going to put the balloons on in a bit more nice way, but we're going to go on a test flight. So let's jump on. We're going to stand here. And of course, I think you all know this. You can spawn a share, put it anywhere in this, and link it to this pod controller. But now we're just going to test flight with the remote control, which is completely okay. So we're pressing R, holding R. Oh, right. Now I forgot that we used the, flashlight for that button. Now I notice that this is too little. We're going to do some adjustments. And as this is going to be airship that I thinking I mostly will stand on, I'm going to change the control to, the numpad. Because then I can turn off and on the flashlight anyways. But when you have a airship, when you're seated, R and F is strongly recommended. Anyways, we're going to put on some screens. That's right. Let's choose the ordinary screen I always use. And we're going to skip ballast. And that's basically the weight that make us not fly away in the air. And by experience, I know this screen is extremely heavy. I mean, it's like a realistic old screen, and that's too heavy. And just no thing. It's very useful to have a control of these. So, oh, really? It was no collided. Well, of course it was. I'm confused. It's very useful to have one of these anyways. Just hold the base prop, and we also want to spawn a speedometer. And speedometer is one of the most hilarious and silly names I ever heard. Speedometer. It measures speed. Oh, we're welding. Wiring. Why am I always saying welding? Maybe I like that sound, I don't know. And this we're going to wire to this, so you know the real weight. And for the real stuff, I noticed that the engine didn't really... It couldn't do with this heavy gear. So we're going into differential, small, and we're going to lower this to... We're going to halve it. To divide it by 2, so we have 11 instead, and we're just going to check how this works. Well, let's jump on. And now we have these controls, it will be a bit easier. So, well, stand still. Come on. Like that. Press. Haha. Get inside. Yes. And now I need to use my both hands with steering. So, let's see. We lift at 90 somewhat. Yep. Let's. Like that. Whoops. There is many things to do at the same time. Aha. Watch my steering. This is quite awesome. Aha. Oh. Okay, I'm rotating around like a freak. Oh, shit. And this is one of the bad parts. You sometimes fall off. Okay. And also, when you stand on it, it gets much lighter when you jump off. That's something you have to notice if you have both a seat on it and you want to stand on it. But you have to adjust for your weight, as you are weightless in the seat, which is very funny. And Well, it still goes in some kind of speed, but we want to change this. Let's just do it in there to a bit lower. I think it's too much. 0.5. No, I mean 0.006. And check this out. Okay, this feels a bit I'm actually a bit afraid of heights, so it's actually quite fun to fly stuff in Gmod, as you don't die when you fall down, and it's very hard to build an airship in real life. And what now? Yeah, this is nicer sound. And this rocks back and forth, which is weird. Okay. And things behave very strange when they're falling. It's a bit fun. Oh, shit. I think we need to X this too. Or X connect. You see what I mean. As the stability was not enough. So. Okay, now we jump on it. And oh crap. I think I'm going to die. I'm falling too fast. We're going to save it from a smash. Okay. What was I thinking? I think the airship. Oh, right, the balloons. The balloons are completely okay in weight. We're on 6,000. We just blast by them. And now I'm going to show you the trick of applying balloons in a nice way. And you actually need one of these. I know. You think, what the hell are you doing right now? But it makes sense. Haha, you put it there. And then you take a balloon. 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 There. And you right click. That's right. And then we are going to take for them, and we're going to collide these two things. And we're going to put them in half visible ways, where there is a low risk that someone can shoot them down with a simple pistol. You can shoot this airship down by using an RPG, as the RPG will destroy the balloons. Well, we're going to weld this stuff together. And now we're going to take a nice color, and that is no color. And now we can remove this one too. You know, this one is a bit vacuum airship over it too. Well, I think we're quite about done now. Of course, you could put some sticks on here to make it look a bit less broken. I'm actually going to do that because I'm a bit annoyed by it. But I still like the model. So let's just check the weight of everything. You never know in Gmod. You don't need weight. Well, this is really craftsmanship here. This is just beautiful. Okay, let's jump on this airship. And we're going to do the real flight. And let's get inside. Seriously? I'm grabbing stuff. I hate that you can grab stuff with E. It's just annoying. Whoever uses it. Just tell me someone that thinks it's practical and useful that you can lift stuff by E. The only thing it does, it is annoys you when you try to build stuff. I think someone made that feature on a very bad day. Okay, now we're lifting. 90, I think it's stable. 90, 100 about is stable for this one. Let's throttle. Yep. I think I put my fins in a wrong angle, so it steers on one side constantly. That can also be an effect, as we only have one propeller. Actually, it would be cool to have counter rotating propellers, but that requires some more job, and on airships it's not worth it. On airplanes and especially helicopters, you have to have it. Well, now we came to the last stage of building this thing, and that is parenting. We're going to parent this. This. So this one is a unit. Then we want to freeze this so it's stable before. And we want to parent those to that one. And then we want to parent all this crimscrams around, all around stuff, you know. Stuff. Not things that are moving, so not the engine and the gearbox, to this base prop. And now we should have a bit more stable airship, so let's jump on it. And we're going to apply some sinking motions. And we're just going to get inside, look up somewhere. I can't grab a stump. Come on. Yes, yes, now we can see. Good. So, I'm absolutely going to save this airship in my you know what? I actually have an airship folder. Yep, I do. How nerdy is that not? I'm absolutely going to save this in the airship folders. But give me a name. What is the name of this airship? This airship. What will be the name of this airship? Well, post it in the comments and I will name it so. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. And, I wish you good luck with your airship building. And, I was just going to fly around some with my new airship. And that would be cool. And now, yep. Let's try that again. Now we have full life. We are less. There is less risk of falling off now. Not less risk, but it's not as dangerous. Okay, give me. Good. Okay, we're inside. It might be good to have a seat because 30 on an airship. Oh, it's a bit dangerous. Usually, it's only safe to walk around on an airship when it moves slower. Well, anyways. Well, if you like this video, please like it. And if you want to see more of these kinds of stuff, well, then you can subscribe if you haven't already. And well, that's basically it, and I think I will say no more and just fly around some. Well, thanks for watching. Geomodism out.